Hi, ladies. It's so good to see all of you. Welcome to our very first virtual annual meeting. I'm so grateful for you and your time tonight, and it's going to look a little bit different than our typical annual meeting, but I know that we're going to have a good time. So I'd like to officially call the meeting to order. The time is 6:32 p.m. and we are going to begin with our association prayer. We pray that we will never be so blind that our small world is all we ever see, or so supremely satisfied that what we are is all we ever hope to be. Grant us the joy of filling someone's need. Make us gracious followers, make gracious those who lead. And more than all, we pray that through the years, we will remember there are always new frontiers. Amen. And the mission? Junior League of Lafayette is an organization of women committed to promoting volunteerism, developing the potential of women, and improving the community through the effective action and leadership of trained volunteers. Its purpose is exclusively educational and charitable. And our vision statement, women as leaders for lasting community change. We have had a lot of loss this year, and unfortunately this past month was no different for our league. So I'd like to offer a brief moment of silence for two members that we lost this past month, Pat Olson and Neri Roy. Thank you. Okay, we are so grateful to all of you who are joining us this evening. I have our administrative liaison, Lauren Swan, and our secretary, Brittany Eskridge, tag teaming this evening to make sure that we establish quorum. And I just got a message that we have, in fact, established quorum. So thank you, ladies, for joining us tonight. We are able to officially conduct business virtually. We are going to begin with our placement recognition by Kathy LaGrange, Placement Chair. Kathy, are you with us?
I'm here, Angel. So it'll be, can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, I just want to be sure. So it'll be a little different tonight because we're not in the same room, and our May recognition is a little different. But we have had so many members this year who have really just gone above and beyond. We wanted to take a little time tonight to recognize a few of these ladies. So I have a few other placement advisors that are on here with us that are also going to help me out. So first off, this member started very early in the year to gather fabulous silent auction items for preview party. She never lets no hold her back, and she made call after call. She was always such a positive part of her committee. She had big goals and worked so hard to crush them. Congratulations, Paige Capel. You got this. I'm going to turn it over to Nicole.
Hello. Our next member had a really difficult job this year, and she made it look so easy. Or you got this. And I'll turn it over to Amelia.
This member is quiet and a calm leader, always brainstorming ways to support and promote each and every committee, as well as the Junior League of Lafayette's overall mission. She is always the first one to ask how she can help and consistently goes above and beyond for the league while managing life and work. The league is lucky to count her among its members. Congratulations, Katie Falgu. You got this. And I will turn it over to Elizabeth Laborde.
The next member is always responsive, is incredibly thorough, and takes feedback like a champ. She is responsible for reviewing every document we produce, and this is no small task. She has been exceptional as our editor this year. Congratulations, Lauren Burns. You got this. And I will pass it to Stacy.
Hi, we would also like to recognize two members for outstanding achievements outside of the league. Katie Guidry has been selected for the 2020 class of the Dole Caregiver Fellow. She was selected from caregivers across the country to represent those Americans caring for a wounded, ill, or injured service member or veteran at home. Congratulations, Katie. You've got this.
Kathy, is that all of the placement recognition for this evening?
No, I have one more. It's me. This is for Nicole Falgu. Nicole Falgu was recently chosen as a panelist for the 2020-2021 Teachers Advisory Panel and was awarded the 2019 College Board Spring Board Teacher of Distinction. Congratulations, Nicole. You got this. And now it's back to Kathy.
Right. So we also wanted to give a really big shout out to everyone out there working on the front lines. I know you've heard it many times, but we have so many members that are really working in very closely with people who are sick, people who are trying to get our community up and running. So we just wanted to give a very big thank you, and we're proud of you. All right, Angel, back to you.
All right. Thank you so much, ladies. That's awesome. And congrats to all of our members who are recognized. Since we have quorum, we are going to move on to our consent agenda, which was emailed in the call to meeting. So the way we're going to do this is if you have a motion to approve the consent agenda, please type that in the text box. In the chat box. Okay, we have a motion from Stacy Bell to approve. And we'll take the second from Roya Bustani. Is there any discussion? Okay. Hearing no discussion, we'll move on to the vote. Are there any objections to the consent agenda? If you have an objection, please type it in the chat box. Hearing no objections, the consent agenda passes. Thank you, ladies. We are going to move on now to our nominating and board development chair, Amy Corvell.
Hi, everyone. Thanks so much for joining us tonight. As part of the PEP package that membership approved, there was a position created for communications vice president elect. So nominating got to work and interviewed the candidates, those who applied and were nominated. And we selected Amelia Pardo for communications vice president elect. And it was announced in a special edition weekly Wednesdays, and now we get to vote on Amelia. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put in the chat box the link for you to copy and paste so we can all take a moment to vote, and Angel will explain a little bit further what we need to do, but only actives and preferred actives are allowed to vote, as a reminder.
Thank you, Amy. Okay, everyone, so if you click on your chat box, We're going to give everybody a minute or two. You'll copy and paste the link, as Amy said, into a browser, and it's going to take you directly to Digital Cheetah, where you will be able to enter your vote and your status. All of these votes will be sent confidentially directly to nominating. So I'll give everyone a minute or two to do that. And if you are having any difficulties, you can reach out on the chat box and someone will assist you. Okay, ladies, while you are taking a moment to vote, we are going to move on to our membership development presentation for this evening and welcome our chair, Jeanette Chauvin. Jeanette.
Thanks, Michelle. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, awesome. Good evening, everyone. Lauren, you can go on to the next slide. I am going to go through a special membership development piece tonight related to books, because we've all been home, we've all been in quarantine, and I felt like this quote helped me get through some of the quarantine. Reading gives us some place to go when we have to stay where we are. And so I'm going to share tonight with you some book recommendations that members want to share with you, and some of them may have helped us get through quarantine, some of them are good summer reads, just a membership development piece of something fun for you tonight. Lauren, you can go to the next one. So here's my PSA. I'm not endorsing any book or any author, just sharing some fun books, some encouraging books, some spiritual books, just friends sharing things that they've enjoyed in quarantine and in life. Don't write all these down feverishly. Don't, you know, type them all into your text message. I'm going to link this in the Wednesday, weekly Wednesday, so that you guys can have all this information. Go to the next one. So our first book is from Angèle. This is a picture of Angèle with her kids and her family during Easter quarantine. And she wanted to recommend The Five Love Languages, The Secret to Love That Lasts by Gary Chapman. And if you haven't read this, I highly recommend it. It's Angèle's number one recommendation to figure out how to make love last. So enjoy some summer reading with that one. Melanie Fowler, our president-elect here in her fabulous garb, going back to work after quarantine with her team, recommends Rediscover Catholicism by Matthew Kelly and The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe by C.S. Lewis. Here's Krista Bio, our board of directors, sustaining advisor with her sons. Andrew recently finished college, and so I wanted to share a picture with you guys. Finishing college in quarantine can't be easy. Social learning, social distance learning. So I wanted to share that picture and share with you Krista's books that she recommends, Jesus and the Jewish Roots of the Eucharist, Unlocking the Secret to the Last Supper, which I ordered on Amazon. I can't wait for it to get here. I was so glad she recommended it. Searching for and Maintaining Peace, a small, I can't say that word, on Peace of Heart by Father Jacques Philippe. Maybe I do need to read that one. And the last one is the Autobiography of St. Therese of Lisieux. I hope that all of you pick that one up. I've read that one. It was a religion assignment at one point in my life, and I highly recommend it along with Krista. Go to the next one. Catherine McCormick here on her quarantine life on her conference calls recommends Redeeming Love by Francine Rivers and The Prophet by Khalil Gibran. Here I am on our boat with my husband, which we did a lot during quarantine. I couldn't pick a book because I picked Jen Hatmaker and then I would have taken up the whole darn slide with her books. And John Acuff the same way, and Brené Brown. I mean, there's just too many books these people wrote. So I took an angle and just recommended authors for you guys. If you pick up any of these authors, I promise that you'll be inspired and entertained. And then the last one that I have on here is Emily Giffen, which is just some fun for the summer. She's got a new book coming out this summer. So I took an angle of just recommending authors. Carly has an entire blog on this topic. I mean, no one could have guessed that Carly had an entire blog on book recommendations. Here she is giving a presentation from her couch during quarantine. Of course, she gave presentations from her couch. Carly's amazing. She recommended The Art of Gathering and Where'd You Go, Bernadette by Maria Simple. And she also says, who should read The Art of Gathering and what is it about this book? And I have all this here that you guys can read. I won't read all this to you, but these are Carly's recommendations. And I'll tell you a little bit about more about her her blog post at the end. You can go on. Lizzie Domang, flying during quarantine. Lizzie, I don't think anybody told you about the stay-at-home order. But anyways, just she and her boyfriend in a plane, so I guess you were safe. Here are Lizzie, as a member of Membership Development's recommendations. Embrace your weird, face your fears, and unleash creativity. The subtle art of not giving, you know what? The E-Myth Revisited, why most small businesses don't work and what to do about it. I think that these are fabulous as well. Putting this together, I was like, oh my gosh, I'm not gonna have enough time to read all these this summer. So many good recommendations. Lizzie, thanks for that. And that looks like quite an adventure. Roya had a birthday during quarantine. Here's Roya during her birthday parade. Roya said she's been a little busy during quarantine with work and Junior League and kids, but Alfred had a recommendation for us on a book. He recommended The Ride of a Lifetime, The Lessons Learned from 15 Years as the CEO of the Walt Disney Company. I mean, if I hadn't already ordered Krista's, I'd be ordering this one. So I guess I gotta get this one on the list. But thanks to Alfred Bustani for that rec. And here's one from Kate Bleacher. She's our Smiles Chair. She's also my neighbor, and so I see her running every single morning, and I'm jealous because I'm stuck in this office, and she's getting some exercise in. Here she is during a morning run on quarantine, and here are her recommendations. Harry Potter, the complete series. She said she couldn't pick one. To Kill a Mockingbird, Where the Crawdads Sing, and Little Fires Everywhere. Kate's an avid reader. I couldn't fit all her recommendations on a slide, so you can reach out to Kate if you need more than what's on here. And here's Katie Duval and her cute little nephew. She also recommends Where the Crawdads Sing. So that's you know, two recommendations for that one. So this one must be really good. And then Revenge Wears Prada, The Devil Returns is also another one that Katie recommends. Okay, so I'm gonna provide this link, like I said. Carly also has tons of amazing recs. I'm gonna link to her blog on the unofficial page so that we can have all of her recommendations because they're unbelievable. And she says, who should read it? Why you should read it? Gives you a little bit of detail before you actually order or borrow or pick up the book. And then I also thought by linking that on our unofficial page, we can have a thread where we can comment because I couldn't include everyone in this presentation, but I wanna hear all of your suggestions. So we'll have a thread going where other people can comment on their books and we can keep it going through the summer and even comment about what we experienced, what we learned, and just create more community for our league. All right, that's my last slide. I wanna read so many of them and I hope you guys too. Do too.
Oh, Jeanette, those were awesome. Thank you so much. That was so much fun.
You're welcome.
I agree. I'm looking forward to having some time to read a book, but I don't know if I'm going to be able to get to all of those.
Not all of them, but I thought it was pretty cool that that was in one location, that you had a, you know, quite a book list from some really smart women. So I hope you guys enjoy it.
Absolutely. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Okay, we're going to move on to our members' years of service recognition, which we traditionally do at our April general membership meeting, which we needed to cancel this year because it was right in the middle of the COVID-19 challenges, but we decided to go ahead and do those this evening. So I'd like to ask Kathy to rejoin us for that.
All right, Angel, I am ready. As Angel said, we usually do this in April with our Volunteer Appreciation Month, but we wanted to recognize all of you for all of your years of service. Thank you, ladies. These are our ladies who are completing 1 year of active service. You finished your first year. You've gotten more familiar with the league. And this year, you really helped us work through this pandemic and keep our league going. Congratulations. All right, for our two-year ladies, this group here makes up one of the largest parts of our community council. You do a lot of the hands-on work for our community partners. So thank you for your work and congratulations on 2 years of service. We have a big group. All right, so let's go to our 3 year. You could forward the slide, Lauren. Oh, it's frozen. So we'll keep, There we go, our 3 year ladies. So this group is a special group to me and to many others, just because I was a provisional advisor this year. This group started our free little libraries. You were able to help us celebrate our 60th year. Your provisional leader is now our president. Our theme was Peace, Love, and Junior League. So thank you, ladies. Okay, 4 years. You spent your first year helping support our community and helping each other get through the flood. And just for an FYI, our diaper bank ideas came out of this helping our community with the flood crisis. So congratulations on 4 years of service. All right, 5 years. 5 years already. Your first year included research on community needs. And one of the things that came out of your year was Kitchen Tour. Kitchen Tour was added to help provide another source of revenue for our league. So congratulations on 5 years. All right, 6 years. This group helped us live our mission by running in our first 5K with Girls on the Run. So congratulations, ladies, for 6 years. 7 years of service. You saw the league pay off our headquarters debt and you transformed our governance structure. Just as the FYI, if you would have had a baby the year you started, they would be in kindergarten now. So congratulations on 7 years of service. 8 years. Your league career started in our 55th year. You helped us create lasting change by building a playground that is still there today. Congratulations. 9 years of service. This year, we redesigned and relaunched 3 of our award-winning cookbooks and saw the beginnings of our endowment fund. Congratulations, ladies. 10 years of service. You've been here a decade already. It goes by so fast. Did you know your year was the first year that we used key cards to get into headquarters instead of a hard key? Congratulations for 10 years of service. 11 years. What a great group this is. At the time when we were provisionals, we were the largest provisional class the league had had to that point. We started when the league was researching the governance structure that we have today. This is a great group. I'm glad to be a part of it with you guys. Congratulations for 11 years. 12 years. I'm sorry, Megan, I don't have a good tip for you this year, but you are the only member left in your 12-year class. Congratulations, Megan, for 12 years of service. 13 years. This is a great group here as well, as we've got some transfers, some leadership positions, and also our next president comes out of this group. Congratulations for 13 years of service. 14 years. Louise Lambert, what a great asset to our group. You got to start your year when we were celebrating our 50th league year. It was our 40th year to celebrate Talk About Good, and it was the beginning of our care bus. So congratulations for 14 years. 15 years. Angel and Julie, you started, or your first year, we were celebrating 10 years of our nutrition program at Boys and Girls Club. And in that year to celebrate, we participated in Kids in the Kitchen. So next year is going to be our Kids in the Kitchen 25th anniversary. Also, you two ladies both serve as president. So congratulations on 15 years. 16, Heather DeValcourt. Your first year, we published our fourth cookbook, Something to Talk About, and we also saw the league win an award for our No Fear, No Future program. Thank you for all you have done for us. Congratulations on 16 years. 18, Sarah Berthelot. There's so much to say about Sarah. Your first year was the first year we moved to our current headquarters building, so you were both new, a new member and a new building. Your class was the first class to serve on our Smiles Committee. If you would have had a child when you first started, they would be graduating high school. Thank you, Sarah, so much for all you've done for the league. Congratulations on 18 years. 19, Maggie Seymour. Maggie, your first year, the league donated to a program called Share the Warmth, where we donated some emergency heating assistance to help with deaths related to inadequate heating in our community. And it just goes to show we have a history of helping our community in a crisis, which is what we're doing this year. You have also served on many committees and many leadership positions, a former president. Thank you so much for your service. Congratulations for your 19 years. And last but not least, Elizabeth Diebold, 20 years of service in the league. Your first year, we donated $25,000 to build a state-of-the-art classroom in the Acadiana Shelter for Girls. You have donated countless hours to our community programs, and I think you have served on almost every single community committee we have. Thank you for your continued service, and thank you for your 20 years. Congratulations to all of you for your milestones. Back to you, Angel.
Wow, that is really incredible. I am so impressed with all of you ladies. Thank you for your years of service. Okay, we are going to move on to our recognition of our outgoing provisional members. Danielle Hines, are you with us tonight?
I am. Can y'all hear me?
We can.
Okay, awesome. I'm very sad that, we're not celebrating at annual dinner like we normally would, but I'm excited about August, and I know we will celebrate then. But it is my pleasure as this year's provisional chair to introduce to you 33 ladies who have completed all provisional course requirements. Although their provisional year was cut short due to COVID-19, these ladies are more than ready to become actives on June 1st. Their year started off with lots of cheering during Super Saturday. They had a great time working Tinsel and Treasures and learning what it takes to raise money for our community. They worked together to choose Moncus Park as our provisional project. They put a lot of work into creating an activity cart that will be housed at the park. The activity cart was to include things like books and science, educational, and art activities for children to use when they visit the park. Because of our current circumstances, the activity cart wasn't able to be completed as planned, but we were able to donate $1,000 for Moncus Park to complete the project. We look forward to seeing the cart when Moncus Park opens in the months to come. This group stands out not just because of their hard work, but the energy and enthusiasm they already have for the league. I have full confidence that we can expect great things from these women as they embark on the beginning of their active years in the Junior League of Lafayette. So congratulations, ladies, that will become actives on June 1st.
Wonderful. Thank you so much, Danielle, and congratulations to all of you ladies. Okay, now we would like to recognize our incoming sustainer members, which of course will get their beautiful roses in August, but we still wanted to recognize them this evening anyway. So Francis, our personnel VP, is going to do that for us this evening.
Hi, everybody. As you know, sustainers are a vital part of our organization. They offer wisdom, perspective, and they put in countless hours volunteering. When I look at the following ladies, I look at a group of ladies that have inspired me and influenced me, and I know that many of you feel the same way. This group of ladies have over 175 years of combined service to our league, and it is my honor to present the names of the following incoming sustainers. LaKenya Jackson, 8 active years. Caroline Poche, 10 active years. Jean-Marie Savoy, 10 active years. Shelley Fontenot, 10 active years. Victoria Kobo, 10 active years. Pamela LaFleur, 11 active years. Stephanie Falgi, 11 active years. Vanessa Ainsman, 11 active years. Allison Dickerson, 13 active years. Louise Lambert, 14 active years. Julie Broussard, 15 active years. Heather DeValcourt, 16 active years. Active years. Maggie Seymour, 19 active years. We look forward to celebrating these ladies when we can gather again in August.
Yay, thank you so much, Frances. We're gonna let you go ahead and move on to candidates for provisional membership.
Okay, so our admissions committee has worked hard this year to provide potential members the opportunity to learn more about Junior League of Lafayette. After multiple information sessions and one-on-one meetings, we are proud to present the names of the incoming provisional class. We cannot wait to welcome these 42 ladies in person when we can gather again. Thank you.
Thank you, Frances. And thank you for both of those presentations. It's full circle seeing all of these beautiful ladies who are joining our sustainer membership. And then in turn, seeing all of these new provisional ladies who are joining our organization as well. So we're just so grateful for everyone and their service, whether you're a provisional and just starting out, or you have given 5 years, 10 years, or 19 years, you are a valuable part of this organization, and we are grateful for you. I'd like to announce that our Communications VP-elect has passed. Congratulations to Amelia Pardo. We are very excited and grateful, and thank you to everyone who placed your votes for this evening. Unfortunately, Caroline Poche had to drop off the call, so I'm going to do her portion of her presentation this evening. Acadiana VOAD stands for Acadiana Voluntary Organizations Active in Disaster, and it's a group that comes together with a collective voice between many nonprofits and organizations in the area to really share and gather information on what are the real-time needs after, before, during, and then after a disaster occurs. The organization began here in Acadiana in 2005 after Katrina and Rita hit, and their bylaws were established in 2016. And Lauren, you can go on ahead. And so we're very fortunate. Caroline serves as our external board rep on VOAD, and she listens in 3 times a week on an hour-long phone call and then reports back to the board of directors on what she's hearing are the needs in the community during the COVID-19 crisis. She's also able to share with these other organizations what Junior League of Lafayette is doing by way of our grants program and our diaper bank. And so she's able to keep these other organizations informed, and then in turn share that information as a two-way link with our board of directors. So we're very grateful to have Caroline and her voice at the table, and she will continue to serve. Although she's becoming a sustainer, she will continue to serve in this capacity until there's no longer a need. So we're very grateful to Caroline. And so that leads me to the next part of this evening. I know traditionally we have our awards at annual meeting, and we get to see our beautiful annual video, and we hear from the outgoing president and the incoming president. And so this evening does look a little different, but I promise you we will get to do all of those things in August. For this evening, though, Melanie and I wanted to really provide you with a state of the league as it is right now, given our situation. So as we see and have seen and are continuing to hear on the news and from Caroline and her work on VOAD. These are undoubtedly unprecedented times in our community, our country, and our world. We've experienced so many successes this year from all four of our councils and have had to deal with so much challenges in the face of darkness. Never in my wildest dreams could I have imagined over a year ago that we would be faced with a worldwide pandemic in the coming months. But somehow our We Got This theme has resonated even more so throughout these months. A year ago, I spoke to you all of perseverance, how not giving up in the face of defeat will give you more personal growth than you could ever possibly imagine. And I'm here today to tell you that as your president, I have witnessed the epitome of perseverance at its very core. The COVID-19 pandemic has forced our organization to halt programs and plans that were already in motion. As a membership of more than 600 women strong, we've changed, shifted, responded, and redirected towards the new way of normal for these times. Our leadership has thought outside the box, brainstormed, researched, and gone back to the drawing board countless times, seeking the best next steps for our organization. Our management team, led by the fabulous Catherine McCormick, has had to work overtime with the changes to our day-to-day operations, while our board of directors has met on an almost weekly basis, monitoring the climate of our economy and how these will affect our league in the coming months. I am extremely grateful for each one of these leaders and their time and sacrifice. And I'm grateful to each one of you, as provisionals, actives, and sustainers, for your dedication to the league, but more importantly, your commitment and support of one another. I am seeing so many beautiful acts of kindness and generosity, and it truly warms my heart. At this time, your board of directors is working tirelessly to project the most prudent decisions for not only next year, but future years to come. It's important for you to know that for over six decades, our organization has served this community, and we will continue to do that for decades to come. In order to do so, we may be forced to make more tough decisions in the coming months. And I have every confidence that this year's leadership team, along with next year's leadership team, will ensure the security, viability, and sustainability of our league. I ask you tonight to put your faith in the team you have elected and know that they will carry us through this difficult time, understanding that Junior League of Lafayette will most certainly persevere. This path to perseverance will continue to be forged by our next leader who has the strength, experience, and knowledge to see our organization through the coming year. I'd like to welcome our incoming president, Dr. Melanie Fallon.
Thanks, Angel. Y'all can hear me, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I want you, Angel, to know that I speak for our entire league to say how grateful we are for you and your leadership. You have been a mentor to every single one of us. You've encouraged us. You've given us that bright smile. And you did your best, and it worked, to give every single one of us an amazing member experience. We are all grateful for you. And with that being said, as we begin this new year, I want all of us to remain in that spirit of gratitude. For just one moment, I would love everyone to think in their hearts about the person or the situation that you're most grateful for. Deep down in your heart, what are you grateful for? I'm grateful for my family, for our Lafayette community, and I'm grateful for this league. I'm grateful for the ladies who will keep us informed through all means of communication. I'm grateful for the members who will provide and plan meaningful member experiences, even if we're not sure what they look like. I'm grateful for the members who will be out in our community directly, even if projects don't look the same. I'm grateful for members who will fundraise in this impossible to fundraise climate. And I'm grateful for the leadership teams who will be asked to give more time and talent and who will have to make difficult decisions in a situation that changes every single day. Last week at the board meeting, I was asked what I learned the most this year. And what I learned the most this year was to be flexible. I said I felt like I was Elastigirl, the mom from the movie Incredibles. Next year may be different. And different is not bad. And different is not scary. It's just different. And so I'm asking each one of you to join me in being an Elastigirl. We can be flexible. And I know we can do it because all of you are intelligent and creative. And like she says, leave saving the world to the men? I don't think so. And finally, I want each of you to please say a prayer for God to give me the courage and the strength, the perseverance, and the flexibility to lead the league through ups and downs, rain or shine, highs or lows. This too shall pass. And I can't wait to see us emerge on the other side, stronger and more confident than ever.
Oh, thank you, Melanie. Thank you for those kind words and your inspiring words. We are excited to see you lead next year's team. And with that, I know I speak for Melanie and myself when I ask that you please save the date for August 11th, where we will celebrate all the wonderful successes of this year when we're able to come together as a large group safely. We also ask that you stay tuned to your weekly Wednesdays throughout the summer. And we certainly want you to have a safe and healthy summer. And I am grateful to all of you for your time this evening. We are coming to the end of our agenda. And I'm so grateful that we were able to establish quorum and vote and get all of our business done. So I really appreciate all of you ladies so much. Do I have a motion to adjourn? If you could text it, Monica Zuschlag. Do we have a second? Catherine McCormick. Is there any discussion? Are there any objections to adjourning the meeting? Hearing no objections, our annual meeting for 2020 is adjourned at 7:20 p.m. Thank you, ladies. I appreciate all of you. Thank you to all the ladies who helped this evening and to make this slideshow and this virtual annual meeting possible. I'm very grateful to all of you. Good night, everyone. We'll see you in August.